Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we will discuss deduplication performance tuning. We will cover a few scenarios in this video. Let us start with reducing CPU utilization on clients during backups. During backups, if a client shows high CPU usage, there might be various reasons for CPU spikes. But to start with, you can check the following. Check if software compression is enabled on the subclient. When compression is configured on the client, the data is compressed on the client computer. The compressed data is then sent to the media agent, which is written to the storage media. Client compression is useful if the client and the media agent reside on separate computers, and the client must send its data using a network. Client compression reduces the network load, since the data is compressed before it leaves the client. On feature release 11.20 and higher, new clients and media agents use the LZO compression scheme by default. LZO compression usually provides faster throughput than gzip, but might result in slightly more data written on the disk. LZO compression usually uses less CPU cycles. You can try turning it off and check if it helps control or solve the issue. Check if deduplication signature generation is enabled on the subclient. When enabled, you can choose to generate the signature, which is a component of deduplication, on the client or on the media agent computer. If it is getting generated on the client, then you can try changing it to generate on the media agent computer and see if it helps control or solve the issue. Before changing the option, you need to consider these. The deduplication is supported on disk storage devices. Therefore, the deduplication options are applicable only if the subclient is associated with a storage policy containing disk storage. For source-side deduplication, the signature generation always occurs on the client. Which means, if the option "enable deduplication on clients" is checked or enabled on the storage policy copy, then source-side deduplication is enabled. When this option is selected, "Use storage policy settings" option is enabled by default on the associated subclient properties. All clients associated to this storage policy will honor the source-side deduplication. Check the number of streams configured for backup on the subclient. Higher number of streams leads to greater CPU utilization. Check the option enabled under number of data readers. If "automatically use optimal number of data readers" is selected, then the software automatically assigns the number of streams or readers required to perform the backup operations. The number of data readers that are assigned are based on the number of nodes configured for the subclient. This option is enabled by default. If "use end data readers" option is selected, then verify the number of simultaneous backup data streams allowed for this subclient. For best performance, except for specialized hardware such as RAID, set the value no higher than the number of physical drives that hold the subclient's data. Check software compression settings on the storage policy copy. If it is enabled, then by default, data is transferred according to compression settings defined by the storage policy copy. You can reduce the CPU usage on the client computer by compressing the data on the media agent. If you do not want to modify the compression settings, you can set SSDT, head max, CPU usage, additional setting on the client computer to allocate certain amount of CPU usage for backups. Set the value of the key as number of thread count or CPU usage percentage. For percentage CPU usage, it is between 1% to 100%, and for thread count, it is between 1 to 50. Lastly, check if antivirus software is scanning CommVault binaries. Ensure CommVault application directories are excluded from the scan. The next topic to discuss is deduplication tuning for block size. This is applicable for data sets that compress greater than 50%, and this occurs for database agents and NDMP. To get higher deduplication reductions for smaller deduplication block size, disable the data compression options. You can disable it from storage policy level. By default, subclients are set to use storage policy settings for compression, unless it is changed. This causes first full backup to increase in size, due to no compression, but subsequent backups reduce as expected. The last topic to discuss is optimizing deduplication percentage on storage policy copy. By default, the deduplication percentage is low on the auxiliary copy, compared to the percentage on the primary copy, because multiple streams are used for high-speed data transfer. However, you can configure an aux copy with deduplication to achieve an optimized deduplication percentage during aux copy operations. This can be achieved by enabling the feature space-optimized auxiliary copy. Configuring this feature helps in keeping the DDB size of the secondary copy close to that of source copy when identical job exists on both copies. The benefits of configuring the feature are: the aux copy operation achieves a higher deduplication percentage by first copying full backups or synthetic full backups, followed by incremental backups or differential backups, as the possibility of same data getting aux copied through multiple streams is reduced. Do note, if there is an error in copying a full backup, then the system makes three attempts to copy the full backup. After the third failure, that particular full backup is skipped from the copying process, and the next backup job is selected for copying. In case the next job is not a full backup, then the system picks up the next available incremental or differential backup without the full backup being fully copied. In scenarios where the data keeps changing and the incremental backups are quite large, using the space-optimized auxiliary copy option helps in reducing the duplicate signature on the DDB, and also the space on the DDB disk. For example, in your CommCell environment, you have scheduled full backups or synthetic full backups to run weekly, and incremental backups to run daily. If you enable the space optimization option, then during auxiliary copy operation, the full backups or the synthetic full backups are copied first in a sequence, and then all the incremental backups are copied. This method achieves a higher deduplication percentage on the storage policy copy. We will end this video here. Stay tuned to the channel for more videos. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.